All right, shalom, shalom, y'all, Shirella. Back at it again with another Lord with the edifying video. Through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Chakorash. Before I go any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Chakorash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and other bishops of Great Millstone, who still go out there in the highways and hedges and feed us with the 100% true according to the Bible and Heruel and Shalom, Labachoyim, Wabarakim, Shoya Shirala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel in the Lashon Kodash, the Hebrew tongue. In the name of this lesson, going to be called through the Spirit, we are blowing the trumpet, we being the true, sincere men of the Lord, starting off with the head apostles and other bishops on down. We're blowing the trumpet, man. Okay, the spiritual trumpet. So, matter of fact, the first piece that we're going to grab is the book of Joel. All right? Because this is a very important to do in these times, man, that we're in. Diligently. This is the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 1. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion. See, the trumpet that we're blowing is the Bible. All right, meaning we're speaking according to the scriptures, right? And Zion, go back to monument to Zion, which was referred to the Israelites. All right, it says, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain, which would be the Israelites. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, it is nigh at hand. See, and what are we supposed to be doing while the day of the Lord or the day of Lord Yahweh Shah's return is soon? Being in these scriptures, man, going out there doing the work of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah, blowing the trumpet. Alright? As a matter of fact, hold on, I got a quick one right quick. I'm gonna go straight to the point. This is the book of 2 Peter 3, verse 11. It says, seeing all these things shall be dissolved, meaning America. When you read up in the 10th verses going into how the ICBMs is gonna freaking burn this place alive. It says, seeing all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? See, all holy conversation, which meaning conduct. Okay, matter of fact, the definition of the word conduct, meaning the manner in which a person behaves, especially a particular occasion or in a particular context. See, in a particular occasion that we're doing this for is so that we can be ready for when Lord Yahweh Shah returns, man. All right, all holy conversation of godliness, meaning all things about the scriptures. All right, so as a matter of fact, verse 12, it says, looking for and hastening unto the coming of the day of Yahweh Shah. It says, wherein the heavens, meaning Esau's rule, shall be on fire, shall be dissolved, meaning destroyed, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. See? So, that's the prophecy that we're looking for. This place being destroyed, and Lozen will be a part of the elect, you know, getting beamed up in those chariots. Man, that's a part of blowing the trumpet. Okay? So, warning our people. So now we're going to go from there to the book of, let's see, Jeremiah. I just wanted to bring that back up, precept. Now let's go to the book of Jeremiah, the 6th chapter. This is Jeremiah 6, verse 17. It says, also I, meaning Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shah, set watchmen over you, which would be the prophet, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. The word hearken means to listen, okay? To pay attention to the sound of the trumpet, which is the Bible, okay? When we break down the scriptures, it says, but they said, we will not hearken, see? And that's what our people do, man, all right? Some of our people, they actually say that, but the majority of our people, they prove it through their actions, all right? Because here it is, everybody know about the Hebrew Israelites, they've seen this on the internet, but guess what? Is the majority of our people doing what the scriptures tells them to do to the best of their abilities? No, they're still living their lives, man. They're still wanting to be in their folly spirit. So, hey, That's blood off our hands, man. Okay? When they see us out there on the highways and hedges, they walk past the word. You know, they act like we're not there. Or they think they got better time, better things to do with their time than listen to the scriptures. Hey, blood off our hands, man. As a matter of fact, hold on. Let's grab that. That's actually my precepts. This is the book of Jeremiah. This is the book of Ezekiel, the third chapter and the 17th verse. It says, "Son of man, I," meaning Yahweh Shemiah, "have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel," which is the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, as well as the Israelite foreigners. It says, "Therefore hear the word of my mouth and give them warning from me." And that's what we do. Okay, we're going to do that Lord's willing later on at camp. And we're doing it now through the videos. Okay? Verse 18, "When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die," meaning if they don't repent, and the wicked meaning to be in our people, the Israelites, "and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way." This is going into the seasonal Israelites. All right? The ones that's not being diligent, the ones that's being lukewarm, being slothful. It says to save his life. It says the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, which means sin upon sin, but his blood will I require at thine hand. See, because you slacked on the job, man. Okay, meaning these other groups out here. Because here it is, they claim that they're being Israelites, that they're so holy. You know what I'm saying? That they keeping the laws and all that, but you're not being diligent. You're not first and foremost teaching the 100% truth of the Bible. And then you're not being diligent, all right? So the ones that pretty much their listeners or their congregation that get put to death, their blood is on the leader's hands, man. All right? And then the Lord gonna put them to death. Verse 19, it says, "Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness," meaning those that's out there, you know, that don't want to repent, those that saw the true men of the Lord, the servants, the prophets, starting off with the head of apostles, the elder bishops on down, that's been doing the work truthfully, sincerely, and diligently, right? It says, "Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness," meaning he don't want to repent, "nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul." See, so that's blood off our hands, man. If you don't want to listen, you want to do other things instead of hearkening to the scriptures, hey, that's on you, man. That's on you. That's blood off our hands, and then let the chips fall where they may. So now let's grab some more precepts. This is the book of Isaiah, the 62nd chapter and the 6th verse. It says, "I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem." And Jerusalem is referring to the Israelites, okay? Because it's a people before it's a place. What proves that? Second Maccabees, the 5th chapter, the 19th verse. Okay? And the watchmen would be the prophets. It says, "Which shall never hold their peace day nor night." See? And on the internet, you know, especially on YouTube, it's flooded with videos, man, of different Akim. Okay? Whether they're in the United States, whether they be in the UK, whether they be in Holland, okay, whether they be in Germany, whether they be in Africa, different parts of the world, man. When the prophets are sleeping on this side of the world, the prophets are out there prophesying on the other side of the world, and it's going up there on the YouTube, on the internet. It says, "Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence." And when you go into the word mention, it goes back to the Hebrew word zikar, which meaning remembrance. See, so when we remember Yahweh Shemiah Shah, once the Lord activated us, or when the Lord sent the Holy Spirit upon us to understand the scriptures, we constantly could talk about Yahweh Shemiah Shah. All right? And we ain't keeping silence. It's time to speak now, speak the prophecies. All right? So now let's go from there. Hold on, Salakia. Let's go from there to the book of Salakia. Let's go to back to Jeremiah. Matter of fact, let's go to this one. Let's go to this one. Let's see what this is. No, Joel. No. Let's go to Jeremiah. Let's see. Give me 1 second, Arkin. Bear with me. Okay. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 25, verse 4. And Yahweh Baal Shemiah Shah have sent unto you all his servants, the prophets, rising early and sending them. But ye have not hearkened, nor inclined your ear to hear. This is referring to the majority of our people. All right? They heard the servants, the prophets. You know, they heard that there was a Hebrew Israelite. All right? And that the God of the Bible is for them. You know what I'm saying? And that they're going to be kings and rulers and all that. You know? But when we tell them what is required of them to do as the Hebrew Israelite, they don't want to hearken. They don't want to listen. All right? We tell them to stop smoking weed, stop gang banging, stop eating pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, you know, for these celebrities out here, pretty much stop putting your time into fame and your wealth and put your time in your how about Shemiah Shah. They don't want to do that, man. Okay? And that's gonna be a reward for doing so. So, let me read this one more time. This is the book of Jeremiah 25:4. And Yahweh Baal Shemiah Shah sent unto you all his servants, the prophets, rising early and sending them. And what are they going to be doing? They're going to be speaking the truth. They're going to be speaking the 100% truth according to the Bible. All right? Which those would be starting off with the head apostles and elders, a great millstone on down to the other camps that are affiliated. That's teaching the truth as well. That's coming in the spirit of great millstone. And it says, but ye have not hearkened nor inclined your ear to hear. See? Because ultimately, because the Lord blinded them, man. Because the Lord didn't want them to get the truth. Alright? So therefore, their lot, if the Lord don't have mercy on them, it's going to be it's destruction. And there ain't nothing we can do about it, you know? So, blood off our hands, man. So, Lord's willing, that was edifying through the spirit of power. Y'all about Shemiah Shah, about Shemachak Wadash. Lord's willing, until next time, I say Shalom.